Advice for aspiring tech reviewers: is installing Yosemite in its beta format safe? We're going to talk G3 versus M8, and we're going to talk some Surface Pro 3 versus MacBook Air. Says the Buffalo. Let's start asking Buffaloes. First question comes from Twitter OG Techies. Asks, at John for Lakers, what advice can you give to new and upcoming tech companies? So I assume you mean like people that want to do tech reviewing, not like OnePlus, this tech startup company. I did a whole series on advice for aspiring YouTubers, and I get this question all the time. I'll put a link down below to check out that playlist, and we'll annotate it here as well, so you can sort of see all those videos that go into how to get products, how to try and get sponsors, how to generate your content, how to sort of conduct your business sort of ethically and separate yourself from the rest of the pack. Definitely go ahead and check those out if you want to get started in tech reviewing or you just want to be a YouTuber in general. Hopefully, it's going to help you. Next question comes from Twitter as well. The Art of Joshua asks, at John4Linkers, is it safe to download OS 10 Yosemite on a primary computer at this stage of beta? Hashtag ask the B. So let me tell you a story. Currently, it is in beta 4. I've been using it in beta 3 for about 2.5 weeks now, and then I upgraded to beta 4. I've had no issues at all with OS 10 Yosemite. It's now in public beta. You can go ahead and get a code pretty easily and go ahead and install it. Now, the one caveat there is third-party applications. That's going to be up to that developer whether or not it's going to work or not work. But in my experience, every third-party app that I use has worked no problem at all. So if you don't use that many third-party apps, use all of Apple's first-party stuff, then absolutely jump in. I'm probably not going to have any issues at all. You might not even notice that it's beta. And a lot of people have said otherwise. My experience has differed. I was having really bad Wi-Fi issues with my iMac at the office. It was disconnecting every 3 to 4 minutes. I did all the updates. I went and talked to Apple, and there was no fix for it. So I figured I would try Yosemite and see if that fixed it. I couldn't justify getting a new computer now, especially this phase in the life cycles. We got new iMacs coming and new laptops. So I tried it, and it fixed the problem immediately. So if you're having Wi-Fi issues on an iMac or a MacBook Pro, then you might want to consider trying Yosemite. Hope it helped answer your question. Next one comes from IamFam143 at John4Lakers. HTC One, M8, and LG G3. Which one do you prefer? So when I first tried the HTC One M8, I was like, dude, it's not gonna get any better than this. This is the best phone that's gonna come out this year. Then I got my hands on the LG G3 and I was like, oh, sweet G3. I love your tiny bezels and your buttons on your back. And I still think that the G3 is the best phone to come out this year. It's gonna be really, really hard to beat that. If you're trying to pick one or the other, I'd be hard pressed to not recommend you pick up the LG G3. Let me stop the questions for a quick second to thank our friends at lynda.com. You know them, you love them, you should learn new things. They offer thousands of super engaging, easy to follow video tutorials that are taught by pros in the industry. You can learn creative software and business skills and everything in between. Membership is super affordable. It starts at just $25 per month and it's online, so it's unlimited 24/7 access. Give it a shot. Try lynda.com free for 7 days by visiting lynda.com/technobuffalo. That's lynda.com/technobuffalo. Learn something new. And the last question comes from at Tweets of Summit, who asks, at John for Lakers, can you recommend the Surface Pro 3 even when I'm thinking about a MacBook Air? If you're thinking about a MacBook Pro, I can totally recommend the Surface Pro 3. And listen, I know I'm in the minority here. I understand that. I love the Surface Pro 3. I like the Surface Pro 2. I am enamored, though, with the third iteration of it. You could easily use it as a tablet. It's light enough. Getting the keyboard dock is awesome. It's powerful enough to be used as a full computer. It can handle games. It's a little bit on the expensive side, but I think you could absolutely use it for the best of both worlds, and I could wholeheartedly recommend it. In fact, I've never said this before, since I'm not doing any more video editing, if I was getting a new laptop for the office, I would pick up a Surface Pro 3 instead of a MacBook Air or a MacBook Pro. The one caveat being I'd wait until the Surface Pro 3 dock comes out, and I could use that with an external monitor. So yes, absolutely, for my money, I think the middle spec i5 with 8 gigs of RAM, 256 gigs solid state is like the perfect middle ground. So you can't go wrong either way, but don't discount the Surface Pro 3. Thank you guys for watching the episode of Ask the Buffalo. I hope you enjoyed. I love answering questions. If you want to have a question featured every Tuesday on technobuffalo.com, we put up a call for questions. You can just leave them in the comments, or if you're more modern, send it to us on Twitter, either to me at John4Lakers or at technobuffalo. Ask your question and use hashtag Ask the B, and we'll pick 3 to 5 each week. Until next week, I am John Rettinger. See you guys next video. Bye-bye. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. We love making these videos, and I hope you like watching them as much as we do making them. If you want to check out more about what Techno Buffalo has to offer, hit the big subscribe button, and you'll be up to date on whatever's coming next.